We basically waited it out for a day, and the water has cleared and has dropped to a point that we can keep moving upriver looking for that golden Dorado.
Absolute clear skies.
But the river has changed. The water is so much higher now. We can go so much faster. We cover 10 miles in half the time that it took before. But the further we go upriver, the bigger the rocks get, and the more difficult it is to navigate with these boats.
Getting too dangerous. The gradient's getting too steep. We almost flipped the boat.
We've made it up about as far as we can go right now. You can't move the rocks anymore. They're too heavy.
Won't be able to make it past those rapids. This is it. From now on, it's all on foot.
This is the final push. Today, we're gonna go as far as we possibly can. This is it.
This is new territory.
We're gonna try to make as much ground as possible before Chris's feet fall off.
Can't even hear the river. We're deep in here.
I'm so exhausted right now. It just shoots straight up. Onward.
I mean, it's almost like vertical, dude.
There's no sure footing. Everywhere you step, it's slippery.
And you can't rely on any of these branches, really. They break so easily.
Or they're covered in spikes.
Don't touch this tree. I just full-on grabbed this tree coming down, and I punctured into the skin. Now my hand is tingly. This is where the jungle starts to eat us. We're going down the esophagus.
I hear the river.
If you can imagine a place on planet Earth where King Kong might exist, could be in this upper region, in this upper jungle for sure. It's a whole different world.
Oh my God, man, you guys are not gonna believe this.
Unreal.
It's like God's playing marbles.
Look at how this river cuts through this canyon.
It literally looks like the river is coming through the mountain.
There's got to be a way around that corner.
They could build a raft out of some driftwood, some cordage they can harvest from the trees up here.
It's worth a shot. We gotta try.
Yeah.
Let's start that raft up.
We gotta go up there. We gotta finish this adventure. I mean, we're thousands of miles from home right now, and we've got to see what's around this corner.
Damn, guys, look at this.
Here we go. So far, so good. The raft is floating, all four of us on it.
We're gonna see what's around this corner. I mean, we're not gonna stop at this point.
You hear that?
Dude, for real. Whoa. What is that? And then there's these screams, these howls.
We just hear these sounds that put goosebumps on my arms and sent shivers down my spine.
I'm gonna get off, guys.
Well, keep us balanced for a second.
Dude, are you hearing that? Are you hearing that?
There are stories of uncontacted tribes on this river that are beyond where that pinch point is. It's like, oh, dang, did we, you know, have we pushed this too far? Have we gone beyond the realm that we are supposed to go to?
We might have reached the end. I just felt like we shouldn't be there and that we shouldn't go any further up this river. He's got one cheek on there. He's good.
Get low.
There's forces that are greater than we have control over. And we're just gonna let the upper headwaters of this river be. We're just gonna let it be.
Well, guys, we came,
saw.
We saw. Now it's time to hit the trail hard.
Came a very long ways for this opportunity. Incredible amounts of work to have just one chance. And I think this is it. And every time I'm about to do some fishing, in my ears, from nowhere comes metal music. It goes a little bit like this.
Ah, you... I don't think he's coming back.
Oh, there he is!
Oh,
come on.
Unbelievable. There he is! There he is! Yeah! Oh, you son of a...
I think sometimes we think that we're just gonna step in and we're just gonna slay fish left and right, you know, and we're not always in control.
The good news is that the water's feeling a lot warmer, and that should get these fish all fired up. Got a Dorado, boys! Finally, we're getting in some fish. Imagine a bar of gold. The feeling of hooking a Dorado, oh, it was incredible. I'll take it. Once you get the fish in and you hold it in your hands, it's one of the most beautiful fish that I've ever had a chance of catching. Damn, that feels good. Looks like there is gold in these waters.
Apparently the fish are here. The rainstorm must have triggered the migration. We were ahead of them the whole time.
Yeah, baby! Yeah! Woo!
As soon as the fly touched the water, it's like an atom bomb went off.
Yeah! Holy!
It's a merciless explosion onto the fly with no delay.
Yeah, I'm gonna swim over there.
That really kind of cut deep into me, the experience of that fish and its eruption.
Oh, 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 come on, come on, come on. God.
Long, long ways to hook into this crazy bar of gold. Come on, like what?
The beauty of the golden Dorado, I could only describe as almost biblical.
All the stories they talk about with the beauty, and it's just a little bit different in person. Okay, here we go. Ready?
You know, we came all this way. There were so many obstacles and hurdles that we had to, you know, overcome to get to this point.
Get him! Yeah, buddy! Yeah! Woo! Yeah! Woo!
And the fishing, we are good, and we did.
Yeah, buddy.
Fly fishing brings me to things that I would never go to.
Look at that thing. That's the most beautiful gold I've ever seen. That is gold, gold.
Ultimately, it's life is about pushing yourself.
Man, that's why we came into the Bolivian jungles right here.
Because once you stop pushing, is your life worth living? Is your life worth living anymore if you stop pushing?
We've been in the jungle for so long, trying to get so high on this river. We've been striking out muddy water, rain, and to hike this far up this river and to have this happen, this is one of the best moments I've experienced in a very long time. Man.
You know, for me, it's more than just the fish. There's so many different things and so many outstanding sceneries and spectacular vistas and incredible rivers and people. And that's why I keep doing what I'm doing.